In this user's guide video, I will try to cover most of functionalities and workflows, trying to reply some of the frequently asked questions. Thanks to everyone who joined Caliper's Master Users Group on Facebook. Your feedback is very important to improve this tool. Let's start with the installation and the updates. First, you need to extract the content of the Caliper's Master 1.2 R2 archive. Then select the Caliper's Master data folder and Caliper's Master Z script and copy them. Now find your current ZBrush installation and open the Z startup folder. Inside you will find the Z plugs folders. Now it is important to locate any previous script version and delete it. Finally, we can paste and overwrite all files. Next time we restart ZBrush, Caliper's Master PAL will appear under the Z plugins menu. Let's try to define some terms for better understanding. First, let's see what a caliper is, and what are the differences versus other transpose lines. Transpose lines are any line created by clicking and dragging on the object's surface with the transpose brush. The main difference with calipers is that calipers are generated by set start and end functions. So it needs two clicks on the object's surface instead of the dragging action. To create a caliper, first click on object's surface and then press set start button. Now click again to establish the ending point and press set end button. The caliper has been generated from the first to the second point. You can use the caliper's master button to do the same functionalities as set start and end buttons. For working faster, you can establish a hotkey for the caliper's master button. So you only need to press your hotkey assigned each time you set a new point on the object's surface. Another difference is that calipers are automatically stored in the stored calipers slider along with the camera position when it was created. So if V is enabled, and we use the arrows to navigate through the stored calipers, you can see the camera is restored in the same position as when the caliper was created. However, we can disable this function by unchecking the V button, so the calipers now will not update the camera view. Now let's try to define what creating a scale is. A caliper's master scale is created when enabling any of the pre-made or custom scales buttons. The differences between both scale types is that pre-made scales does not need any caliper as reference for establishing the initial distance. So when using pre-made scales, we only need to enable the unit we want the object to be exported. Let's select millimeter scale and measure the width of this cube. It is 0.4 millimeters width. Now let's see the size in ZBrush units under a geometry palette. It is 0.4 as well. So when using pre-made scales, calipers units and ZBrush size units will match. Let's change the size to 10 ZBrush units. Now if we use calipers to measure its width, we get 10 millimeters as expected. Okay, let's undo this last size modifications to restore the cube to its original size. Now let's see how to create a custom scale and the differences between both. The main difference is that we need to establish a caliper to represent the initial distance and enter an initial value before creating the custom unit by pressing any of the custom scales buttons. So let's create a caliper representing this cube height. If we get its distance, we see it is still in the original value of 0.4 units. But, if we enter a value of 10 in the initial scale, and we press custom millimeters, now the caliper distance is 10 millimeters. And of course it will be exported in 10 millimeters. Notice that in this mode the Z brush units are not affected at all. And we can use this in our benefit, as we'll see later on this video. Now, if we disable our custom scale, the cube will be restored to its original scale. And now it is at 0.4 in height as it was originally. Now let's try to determine what a temporary scale value is, using an example. In this case, we want to append a dog in the scene directly in the right size. If we just copy the model and paste it into the scene, we can see it is very small in comparison to the scene scale. We could scale it up manually, but it is a bit tedious, and sometimes we need to be precise with our design specifications. Let's say this dog height from ground to top of the hips should reach exactly the waist of this trouser. We can memorize the distance value, and enter it later in the append in size. But we can also use a temporary scale value of 1 mm, and append the dog in that exact size. So let's create a scale of 1 mm for this caliper from the ground to the trouser's waist. And now let's do the same for the height of the dog, from ground to top of the hips. To force this caliper to be 1 mm, we should enter a value of 1 in the appending size slider. So now it has the same distance as the value we entered initially when creating the scale. We can now copy the dog model and paste it into the scene. This time, in the right size. So we simplified the scale of both objects, forcing them to match 1 mm in caliper's distance. Finally, we can restore the original scale and check that everything is as it was originally. Let's see how to define a project scale with Calipers Master before start modeling and what is the ideal size for dyna-meshing. The first thing to do is to create a cube to use it as a reference of the scale. Then, press Unify button under Deformation Palette. We can see that the size after pressing Unify button is 2 ZBrush units. Now you can play with the Dynamesh resolution until you have your desired polygon density. But let's take a look more in depth to the relationship between Dynamesh resolution and the size of the polygons created. In the Dynamesh palette, let's set the blur slider to 0, and disable the projection function for working faster. Now enter a value of 32 in the resolution slider and enable Dynamesh. Now I will create a custom scale of 1 polygon wide using this Dynamesh resolution. So each unit is now 1 polygon size. Now let's measure this cube from side to side to get the average number of polygons. For this task, I'm using the height in X mode. This way I just need to click on any area of the flat surfaces on both sides of the cube when creating the caliper, and it will be constrained automatically to the x-axis. The result is that we have 32 polygons. The same value as the Dynamesh resolution we are currently using. Let's see what happens if we increase the Dynamesh resolution to 512 and repeat this process. First, we need to establish the polygon wide as our unit. Now we can do the same as before and measure how many polygons wide is the cube. As expected, it has 512 polygons wide, same as the current Dynamesh resolution value. This ideal relationship between number of polygons and resolution only happens when we are working in 2Z brush unit size. So I like to start the projects considering that the total size of the main objects should fit inside a unified cube. Let's say we are working in a scale of 28 millimeters. The first step is to create a caliper representing the height of the initial cube. Then enter 28 in the initial value and press Custom Millimeters button. Now the cube on screen will be printed at 28 millimeters when exported. If we want, we can store this custom scale for later usage. This way we can reload it in future sessions. Notice that if we save the project while having the custom scale enabled, the current scale will overwrite the original scale. Now that we have established the scale, we can start modeling considering the cube as the scene boundaries. Or we can import other tools inside the scene. If we want to import tools in the correct size, we can use the Append in Size feature. For example, let's import the dog model inside the cube. We just need to create a caliper from nose to the tip of the tail, and establish the size we want it to have when appended in the scene. In this case, I want it to have 28 millimeters to fit exactly inside the cube boundaries. To do this, I just need to enter a value of 28 in the appending size slider. Then I can proceed copying and pasting under the destination tool. As we see, it fits perfectly inside the 28 millimeters cube. Let's add another tool into the scene using the same process. First, we need to represent the total height of the model with a caliper. Then, we need to enter the value we want the model to have when appended. In this case, 28. Now we can proceed copying and pasting as before. As we see, the new tool has been imported in the right size. Now we will take a look at the view in real size functions to have an accurate idea of how our models will look after printed. Let's preview the 28 millimeter scale first. The only thing we need to do is press View in Millimeters button. Now the object is displayed on screen in real millimeters. Let's see how this model would look if it were printed at 55 millimeters height. And now let's see it at 75 millimeters. Notice I am storing them on screen by using the snapshot feature in ZBrush. So we can use temporary scale values to preview our model in different scales very easily on screen. If we are happy with the previews and we want to have the objects actually duplicated in different scales, we can use the Append in Size feature. For example, let's take the 75mm scale soldier, and let's duplicate it but in 28mm height. As we already have the caliper representing the total height of the model, we only need to enter the desired value in the appending size slider and press Append in Size. The soldier is now appended in 28 millimeters height. We can play with the view in real size functions and check that it has the same size as the previous snapshot stored. Now let's append another copy but in 55 mm. Just enter a value of 55 and press Append in Size button. So we can easily compare and duplicate objects in different scales using the View in Real Size and the Append in Size features. That's all for this Calipers Master 1.2 User's Guide. Feel free to comment and ask any questions on our group on Facebook. If you enjoyed it and want more videos, give it thumbs up and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thanks for your support. See you on next video.